principle done a lot of, so we don't need to focus on that anymore. We'll be doing lots of modeling examples in the context of problems that we're solving. So now I want to start introducing some of the machinery we need in order to solve the problems of interest to us. And the first one is going to be the main tool is something called Laplace transform. I'm assuming you guys have seen this in some context for a solution of differential equations. And I think everyone has the same background now. So the problem we're going to be interested in is one that looks like this. And some system or process, let's call it P. I have some input variable, call it U. It might change with time. Okay. And I have a model of this particular process, and let's say in the sense of differential equations. And I'm interested in calculating what the output of the system is. So in the context of any problem, I have to tell you what the input is and how it changes. And you have to either have a model of the process or derive one, and then your goal is to calculate the output. Okay. So we'll call this calculating the output in the sense of the dynamic response of the system. And this is something we didn't really cover in 361, because in 361 we never considered an input that might change with time. Okay. I would give you maybe an initial condition, and you would calculate how the system responds as a function of the initial condition, but never for a time-varying input. Okay. And therefore, there's a more convenient tool to solve problems that look like this, and the tool is this Laplace transform. Okay. So what I'm going to do is introduce it, basically define it. I'm going to show you how you can use it to solve linear differential equations. I'm going to go through and show you how to apply the Laplace transform to some different functions. But when you're actually solving problems, you'd be wise to use a table. It's a lot easier. Okay. There's a table in your book. It's probably table 3.1, I think. But I don't want the table to appear like black magic, so I at least want to derive a few so you can see where the entries in the table come from. Okay. But we won't be deriving these things, generally speaking, just using it. So I'll show you how to use this to solve differential equations. I'll go through an example. Transient is another word for dynamic. Okay. You know, unsteady state, dynamic, transient all mean the same thing. And then I'm going to land a preemptive strike of sorts by showing you how you solve this problem in Simulink. Simulink's an add-on to MATLAB. It's convenient because you can represent systems in pictures like this. So-called block diagrams. Input goes into a block, output comes out. So it's very convenient for control system design and analysis. So, I mentioned this at the beginning of the class, is you're going to need Simulink. Okay. If you bought the student version, you have it. If you didn't, then you may or may not have it, I can't say. Alright? But you'll need it. And Friday, what I'm going to do is start introducing in more detail how you use this. And then, you know, Fridays, you know this story, right? Come in with your computer. I'm always surprised how few people do. I'm not sure what they're doing. But anyway. You come in with your laptop so you can run the examples, begin to learn how to use it, so all the learning doesn't take place on the homeworks. Okay? Because the homeworks are more complicated than the examples in class. Alright, so here's the definition of the Laplace transform. I assume you've seen it before, but my guess is you don't.